Welcome to K-pop Basic Lessons. In episode 1, we learned about 8 different positions in an idol group. In episode 2, we discussed major K-pop entertainment companies. Today in episode 3, we'll discuss 4 generations that define K-pop from 1992 all the way to the present. The first generation of K-pop lasted from 1992 to 2003 with groups like H.O.T., TXKIS, SES, and Pinkr. Music was a mix of rebellious messages against mainstream society and sweet love lyrics, lots of allusions to forever. They usually released full albums with 10-plus songs and had longer promotion cycles. The industry was relatively new, so many idols debuted without a super formal training system. Second generation of K-pop from 2003 to 2013, with groups like 동방신기, Super Junior, Big Bang, Wonder Girls, Girls' Generation, Kara, SHINee, 21, T-Ara, and FFX. The 2.5 generation refers to the tail end of this era, from 2010 to 2013, with Girls' Day, Infinite, SISTA, Miss A, EXO, A-Pink, Korean Pop, and many more. Music still sang about love, but we see a shift towards catchy sounds and melody. Simple dances everyday fans can follow becomes a hit. Rap becomes more mainstream, and idols release full albums with 1 or 2 hit songs and a 4-week promotion period. The K-pop training system becomes more formalized during this time. International success became more common with 동방신기 and Kara topping Oricon charts in Japan. K-pop starts to spread more in Europe with a flash mob to ask for another day of SM concerts in Paris in 2011, and we start to see more non-Korean members. The third generation of K-pop from 2014 to 2018 featured groups like Red Velvet, Mamamoo, Twice, Blackpink, I.O.I, GOT7, NCT, Monsta X, iKON, and 101. We see a stronger emphasis on catchy melody rather than just the lyrics themselves. Idols release single albums and promote for 2 to 4 weeks. Idol audition programs became very popular during this time, and we see more and more non-Korean members. There is some debate about whether we are currently in the 3.5 or 4th generation, from 2018 to now. We see groups like IDOL, IZ*ONE, Stray Kids, ITZY, TXT, Everglow, Treasure, and aespa. K-pop music now mixes multiple genres into one song. The music emphasizes more performance than just listening. Idols release digital singles, promote for 2 weeks, then 2 to 4 months later release another single, then a repackage album. We see more and more idols writing and producing their own songs, and this adds merit to the group. Regarding communication and fan culture. During the first generation, idols communicated with their fans through very traditional forms of media: TV, radio, newspaper, and magazines. Fans communicated to their artists through fan letters. International performances existed, but were limited to China and Japan. BoA was one of the earliest idols to make it big outside of Korea. During the second generation, with the help of the internet, fans organized themselves through an official fan cafe online. Although it existed before, it became more common for each fan club to have a name, like Wonderful, SHINee World, Blackjack, and XOL. Dance covers start to spread globally as platforms like YouTube become more mainstream. During the third generation, K-pop idols communicate more directly with their fans through social media like Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. Fans start to carry Taepo camera or large cameras, and fan cams become more mainstream, especially because online photo and video sharing becomes easier and easier. During the fourth generation, idols continue to use social media, but we see a rise in fan-specific apps like VLive, Weverse, and Lyson for more exclusive, real-time communication. Idols also create their own content and control the distribution channel. Subtitles become readily available. Most companies release lyrics in both Korean and English, unlike 10 years ago when you had to wait a few days for multilingual fans to translate everything. Regarding merchandise. During the first generation, the concept of official merchandise didn't exist yet. Instead, you could buy writing pads, posters, and book covers. You could also wear the color representing your member. When you go to concerts, you made your own signs. During the second generation, every K-pop group had their own color balloon. Big Bang actually was the first group to ever have a light stick, and it became a little bit more popular later. It was still common to decorate your own signs at concerts. During the third generation, it was more common for every group to have a light stick, key ring, fan, t-shirt, sweatshirt, hat, etc. This is when albums started to get more and more fancy as people stopped listening to CDs and albums became more of a souvenir. Shinwha was the first group to start photo cards, and now it's a lot more common for each album to feature photo cards. During the fourth generation, having a light stick is definitely a given, and you see everything from dolls to toothbrushes to co-designed branded deals. Which K-pop generation do you identify with most? Are we in 3.5 or fourth generation currently? Who is the most iconic group from each era? Let me know in the comments below. My name is K-pop Sociology, promoting the critical consumption of K-pop. Remember to 구독, 좋아요, and 알람 설정.